Hello everyone, Vincent Teo from HDTV Test here. Recently, Panasonic celebrated its 100th birthday in Palma, Mallorca. I'm really sorry I couldn't be there because I'm celebrating something else in my home country of Malaysia. But whatever I missed, you know, my kind colleague David McKenzie has actually fed it back to me. So I just wanted to stand here and say happy birthday to Panasonic. It's been a great achievement, you know, celebrating 100 years in existence with lots of exciting and innovative products throughout the years. So congrats again. But what I wanted to talk about in this video are the new LED LCDs that have been launched by the Japanese brand in Mallorca. So the company, in short, launched four new ranges of LED LCDs to go with the OLED TVs that have been revealed at CES earlier this year. So we know that there are two ranges of new OLED, the FZ950 or 952 and the FZ800 or FZ802. And those are the OLEDs, but for LED LCDs, there will be the top tier FX780, or in the UK, it is also marketed as the FX750. And then the step down range will be the FX740. In the UK, this is going to be a Kairis exclusive. And then one step lower will be the FX700. And then the entry-level LED LCD will be the FX600. And I think of most interest to people who care about picture quality may be the top tier FX750. But even then, I think if you look through the specifications of the FX750 or FX780, it is very clear that Panasonic has actually implemented a two-tier strategy for their televisions. So at the high end, you get OLED, but for the masses, the FX750 and below, it actually just highlights the divide in terms of what Panasonic thinks is going to be the future of high-end and premium televisions going forward. So let's go through the specifications of the FX750 or FX780 in the first instance. It will come in four screen sizes. It will come in 49-inch, it will come in 55-inch, it will come in 65-inch, and it will also come in a massive 75-inch model. Now, I've been informed that except for the 75-inch FX750, all the rest of Panasonic's LED LCD for 2018 will be using IPS panel. Now we know that IPS panel will have better viewing angles than VA type LCD panel, but the contrast performance will not be as good. By that I mean that the blacks will be weaker, and it will be interesting to see how this translates to HDR impact, especially when you consider that none of the LED LCD that is being produced by Panasonic in 2018 will be using full array local dimming or FALD technology. All of them will be HLED, although the top tier FX750 and also the FX780 will be using what the company is calling the local dimming pro technology. What this means is that they are going to be using software and processing to try and shutter out some lights and block out some zones, trying to boost the number of zones using a software method. And also I need to tell you that although Panasonic is saying that the peak brightness of its 2018 LED LCDs are higher by 20% across the board compared with the 2017 models, what this means is that the peak brightness is now 600 nits rather than 2017's 500 nits. So when you combine all these factors together, even the top tier FX750, what you are going to get is an IPS panel, what you're going to get is an HLED LED backlight configuration, and what you're going to get is a peak brightness of only 600 nits. And although it will also have HDR10 Plus technology to help deliver better tone mapping for both the darker parts and the brighter parts of the image, you know, because of the scene by scene metadata optimization, what you are going to get is not I don't think, you know, it will be as good as, let's say, a true full array local dimming LED LCD with a high number of zones, let alone an OLED. So from this perspective, it is very clear what Panasonic is trying to do, and I cannot fault them from a business perspective, because if you want to build an LED LCD that can begin to compete on the picture quality level with OLED, you will need a VA type LCD panel, you will need full array local dimming, and you may need a quantum dot filter. And when you add these things together, the cost will just spiral. So let's say if you want to put full array local dimming, the chassis will get thicker, and then if you want to actually provide more discrete number of zones, then the cost would go up. The more LEDs that you use in a television, the price will be higher. And if you want to actually implement a white color gamut by actually putting in quantum dot filters, then the cost would just go up as well. And when you add up all these costs and the bulky design, the price would probably just come close to OLED. And we have seen over the past couple of years that consumers, when they go out there, when they are spending above a certain amount of money, they would rather spend it on an OLED rather than an LED LCD. So there's really very little incentive for any manufacturer out there. This doesn't only apply to Panasonic, this applies to everyone. And we've seen a similar business strategy from Philips, in that their top tier premium products are OLED, whereas their 8 series are all IPS. And Panasonic is adopting the same approach here, because this is the only approach that makes business sense at this moment in time. Because, as I said, if you want to build a truly high quality full array local dimming LED LCD, you are getting into OLED territory. And research have shown that consumers would rather spend the money on OLED. There will be very little demand for the LED LCD. I would think that this is probably the same reason why Sony is persevering with its Sony ZD9 as its flagship LED LCD for 3 years in a row. And Panasonic do not really want to go down this route where they are actually putting out a full array local dimming LED LCD that won't get sold. So unfortunately, the last truly great LED LCD from Panasonic is likely to be the DX900 or DX902. But like I said, you know, every TV brand out there is in the market to try and make some money, to try and generate a profit. And however much us video enthusiasts want a company to build a really great full array local dimming LED LCD, it just doesn't make business sense anymore because of the competition from OLED, with the prices of OLED getting cheaper and cheaper. I mean, the B7 55 inches is only down to £1,500. It's going to be extremely difficult to compete with that. So Panasonic's strategy makes sense, but I'm here to tell you that the FX750, even the highest end LED LCD from Panasonic for 2018, will only have 600 nits of peak brightness. It will have an IPS-based LCD panel, and it will have an H-lit lighting system. This is Vincent Teo here, reporting from Malaysia, and I'll be flying back to the UK very soon. But before you sign off, I would like to say happy 100th birthday to Panasonic again. At the end of this video, there's a short 1 minute snippet that I've put together. Hopefully you'll enjoy it. I really, really like the ethos of this Japanese brand. I really dig their video processing and the picture quality that they are putting out. And if you found this video useful, please click the like button and subscribe to the HDTV Test YouTube channel for more videos like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.